Madge Wheeler always vowed she'd never remarry until the last of her three children left home. But when she began her search for someone special 7 years ago, it proved tougher than she'd thought. Lonely Hearts advertisements in a local newspaper brought plenty of replies, but not of the kind she'd imagined.
The first thing they suggested was the bed the first night, and their answer was not on.
In fact, as Madge now admits, some of the people she found from her newspaper ads were really quite an eye-opener.
Very strange indeed. One that I left in the hall because I wanted to see something on the television, went back in the hall and he was completely a lady. Mask, wig, the lot. So I completely showed him the door and I haven't seen him since.
But then Stan Cox wrote to Madge, a single man from Caddington near Luton. He'd been having similar problems.
It's really the reverse to me. The women all seem to be looking for dirty weekends that I met, and Madge was entirely different. You know, they seemed to like a dirty weekend, and I wasn't looking for that.
But even after Stan and Madge met, it was by no means love at first sight. Stan was unsure, and Madge was still methodically working her way through the 19 hopefuls who'd replied to her last plea for a husband.
Well, I invited them all back, and 11 decided to come. I dwindle it down to 8, and then Stan, I chose Stan.
So what put Stan ahead on points then?
Because he just didn't suggest sex. He just wanted me as a companion. He was genuine, he was very fond of me, and I could tell that.
But how did Stan feel about being in a 19-strong race for Madge's hand?
She did tell me she had other replies, but she didn't tell me I was on a shortlist. I didn't know that until she picked me.
So how soon did you decide to pop the question?
Well, it's been about a week, I should think.
Both of you now are looking forward to your wedding day, which is going to be next month. Do you think you've got lots of happy years together?
Well, I hope so, yes. We're both, thank goodness, healthy, and we want to live at least 20 years, I do, with good health and happiness.
That's what we hope, don't we?
Madge and Stan's wedding day is planned to be a family celebration. Madge has thrown away the remainder of her Lonely Hearts applications, and the future looks bright. Steve Clark with the prospective newlyweds for Thames News.